Let us do some problems in geometric progression. Here, the first problem given, find R, that is common ratio, and nth term of the geometric progression, that is An, for the list of numbers 2, minus 6, 18, minus 54. This is in a geometric progression. So, we have to find out the common ratio and the nth term. So, how we will find out the common ratio? R is equal to A2 by A1, or we can take it as A3 by A2. Like this, we can find out the common ratio among these list of numbers. So, here the first term is 2. That is A1 is equal to 2, A2 is equal to minus 6. So, if you have confusion, write it down. A1 is equal to 2, A2 is equal to minus 6, A3 is equal to 18, and A4 is equal to minus 54. So, common ratio in the geometric progression, A2 by A1. A2 is minus 6 by A1 means 2. So, we'll get 2 ones are 3. That is equal to minus 3. Let us check with the other set numbers also. A3 by A2 means A3 is how much? 18 by A2 means minus 6. 6 ones are 6 threes are. Again we get minus 3. Here we have minus 3. Here also we have minus 3. Next we can check with the fourth and third terms also. How? A4 by A3. That is equal to A4 means minus 54 by A3 means 18. 18 ones are 18 threes are. So, here also we have minus 3. So, according to the definition of the geometric progression, we'll have multiplying the preceding term with a fixed number. So, here we have the fixed number, that is minus 3. So, common ratio is equal to minus 3. Next, we have to find out the nth term, that is An. So, An is equal to, we have here the formula An is equal to A into R power n minus 1. This is the nth term of geometric progression. So, according to that formula, An is equal to A into R power n minus 1. So, here A is the first term, R is the common ratio. So, what is the first term in this list of numbers? That is 2 into R, we have minus 3 power n minus 1. So, this is the nth term of this list of numbers. This is the first problem. Next, in the second problem, find the 10th and nth term of a GP 5, 25, 125. These are the list of numbers. So, first, to avoid confusion, we can write as A1. That is, first term is 5, A2, 25, A3, 125. So, here we have already A1, which is first term, 5 we know. And now we have to find out the common ratio. So, R is equal to A2 by A1 or A3 by A2. So, here we have only 3 numbers. So, 3 terms we can write. Now, A2 means 25 by first term, that is 5. So, we have 5. So, here we have 5. Next, check with the third and the second terms. A3, it is 125 by 25. So, it is also 25 5 is 125. So, we have So the fixed number here is 5. So r is equal to 5. Now we have to find out the nth term. So what is the formula for nth term? An is equal to a into r power n minus 1. So here a is the first term, r is the common ratio. Nth term means an is equal to a. According to this sequence or list of numbers, a is 5 into r we have 5 power n minus 1. So this is the nth term. Now we have to find out 10th term. So n is equal to 10. So substituting in the place of n, 10, then we will have 10th term. Then a10 is equal to 5 into 5 power n is equal to how much? 10. 10 minus 1. Then 5 into 5 power 10 minus 1 means 9. So 5 power 9. So here 5 power it is 1. Therefore, these are bases are equal. So we have can add the powers. Therefore, 5 power 1 plus 9. That is equal to 5 power 10. This is according to the law of exponents and powers. We can write as a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. This is according to the law of exponents. So, 10th term is equal to 5 power 10. This is the answer.